So this is the second intuitive Kahoot. First question is, what is the word below? And you can see we start off with several underscores, and slowly characters are coming forth. Below we have answers, and the answers start to make sense. So this is sort of a Wheel of Fortune style question. At some point, the answer should be obvious to the student or guessable to the student. So it's sort of a fun way to have them begin playing with the word, whether they're familiar with it or not. So even if they had never heard of the word OpsiMath, they can answer this question, and it's a fun way to play through it. So we still don't know what OpsiMath means, but we've played with it, and now we're just trying to figure out how many syllables. So we can just say the word OpsiMath, OpsiMath, three syllables. So we have our students really looking at the letters, saying out the syllables, so their mind is really processing this word, whatever it means. And in question three, we go ahead and just define it. An OpsiMath is someone who starts or continues to learn late in life. And the image just says, give me an example. So it's not a picture of something, but an extension of the question. Give me an example. And so we choose an elderly janitor going back to college. If we look at our two examples, a child getting straight A's versus an elderly janitor going to college, that's the only one that makes sense. It's not a terribly difficult question. It should be obvious from what's given. An OpsiMath is someone who starts or continues to learn late in life. And if we wanted to, we can continue with another question or another set of questions, getting more and more complex, really defining the limits of our understanding for OpsiMath or whatever it is that we're trying to get the students to know. But for us, we just move on to the next topic. By definition, a blank is a person of wide-ranging knowledge. And so this deviated somewhat from the definition of OpsiMath. So for me, this means it can't be OpsiMath, and so it has to be this other word, polymath. So we've begun introducing a new word, polymath. We've gotten another use out of OpsiMath. And so we can continue to introduce and build up our understanding of polymath, and one or two questions later, come back, review OpsiMath to whatever extent we want. Make it a more difficult one, a more difficult question, refine our knowledge to whatever extent.